Today we'll be discussing about the career options in aviation industry. As we know that aviation industry is a really booming sector and it will be in the top three industries by 2030. So today we'll just have a look at the few career options in aviation industry, which are HR, marketing, finance, and SEO. These are just a few options which we'll be discussing, and aviation is a vast field. It has plenty of career options and job profiles. So talking about HR, HR is the division of a business that is charged with finding, screening, recruiting, and training job applicants. And also it includes administering employee benefit programs. HR, it plays a key role in every industry these days, as it is very difficult for the company in this competition to recognize that which employee will be beneficial for them. So HR plays a major role in that case. And also in some other functions, including like, so the role of HR, it's like determining the needs of the staff and seeing that the staff is working properly and determined to use the temporary staff or hire employees to fill these needs. And making sure that the staff is working in the proper managerial process and do not just like every other industry, HR and aviation plays a key role, as I just mentioned, and it offers its customers the enjoyable and comfortable way to travel. Airlines looking for ways to improve in at least these two areas, even in low-cost air carriers, HR plays such a part when it comes to recruitment of pilots and hiring of mechanics to maintain the aircraft. Maintenance of general service conditions, disciplinary matters, performance appraisals, and effective implementation of social security schemes, which includes superannuation benefits under the ambit of government guidelines and pension schemes. And also HR, aviation is such a growing industry. Even for an example, in my class, in my college, there are the most strength present is in aviation. So I see how tough the competition is and how tough it is actually for an HR to determine the best employee for the organization. So I guess HR is like a key job profile in every organization, and we see it in every industry these days. Just for a salary insight of an HR, for example, I have taken Air India. Average Air India HR manager salaries in India is like 5.9. We can take it as an average for 6 lakhs for employees with work experience between 7 years to 11 years. Whereas an HR manager salary ranges between 5.7 lakhs to 6 lakhs. And for example, for Indigo, HR executive salary in India is 4 lakhs for employees with less than 1 year of experience to 9 years. And executive salary ranges between 3 to 5 lakhs. So the experience and the airline also determines with the salary that you would be expecting. So I'm just taking insight of the history would be better so that the employees expectation does not get disappointed. Now talking about marketing, it's like a definition of marketing, a set of processes that are interconnected and interdependent with other functions of a business aimed at achieving customer interest and satisfaction. In other words, marketing refers to activities a company undertakes to promote the buying or selling of a product, service, or a good. And the role of a marketer these days, it's like overseeing and developing marketing campaigns, conducting research and analyzing data to identify the defined audiences, devising and presenting ideas, promotional activities, writing, monitoring performance, managing campaigns on social media. Marketer has to oversee that the company's policies, benefits, and its products are reached out to the customers in a proper way and that they see it how it will be beneficial to them. And it sees that customers are not under some rumor or a false review that is provided by audience, and it is very common these days. So importance of a marketer is to increase the sales by providing the benefits, the long-term benefits, and meeting the customer's needs and wants. Our customers' needs and wants changes every day. Like, I mean, in these growing industry technologies and everything, every quarterly or annually, I guess, 3 to 4 times or uncountable times, the needs and the expectations might change of a customer. So it's really important to meet the needs and wants with the growing technology, and also ensuring the organization's survival, growth, and reputation, management of demand, economic growth, better product offerings, adapting the right price, and widens the market. A marketer is to see that the product and the customers are both aligned parallelly so that it grows rapidly and does not face a loss or a decline in the sales. And talking about role of marketer in aviation, the airline industry, we all know that it's an oligopoly market structure. So it is a form of imperfect competition in which a limited number of firms dominate the industry. Oligopoly firms have market power in setting or altering price for their products by establishing various output levels. Oligopoly market, we know, like, it's a market where small firms, they all combine and make a huge market, and it's in a competition. So but mainly the marketer establishes corporate brands, develop advertising campaigns, achieve sales goals, and shape public opinion for companies ranging from aircraft and avionics manufacturers to airlines. The job may also require working in sales in order to generate more cargo for the airline. This will include communicating with the air carriers, cargo freight forwarders, and other businesses. So basically, marketers these days have established campaigns and through social media, some activities, some discounts and everything, just to make sure that the firm is in liquidity and it is working smoothly to meet its profits and to meet its expectations. And also, as it's mentioned, for more cargo for the airline, it should be, it has to make sure that the customers or the industries that have to transport the cargo have to see the benefits that the airline will be safe and that the cargo transportation will be safe and sound and will be on time. So it also involves working with others on the team to create ideas for marketing campaigns, slogans, logos, and being able to write the ad copy. Ideas and campaigns for special offers will also need to be created. Airlines and airports are currently expanding the number of terminals and aircraft in an effort to meet this expected increase. As the competition becomes greater, so will the need to create ongoing and ad campaigns and from various forms of marketing to reach the target market. People who are traveling and companies with cargo that needs to be delivered, this job will be in demand for a long while to come, and there are possibilities for advancement in especially larger airlines. A salary insight of a marketer, for example, in Air Canada, with 4 to 5 years of experience, it would be $68,000 to $87,000 annually, whereas for a senior marketing salary in Air India, for example, would be 7.2 lakhs to 9.2 lakhs per annum, and it is based on salaries received from employees of Air India Airport Services. These are some of the skills that a modern marketer might look through as hard skills and soft skills, such as analytics, content strategy, social media, mobile, e-commerce. These are all hard skills which might impact the audience in a large manner, whereas soft skills are something which would be inside and there should be given attention to as well, such as creativity, resourcefulness, adaptability, collaboration, and leadership. So finance is the other career option which we'll be talking about. So finance is defined as the management of money and includes the activities such as investing, borrowing, lending, budgeting, saving and forecasting. There are basically main three types of finance. Personal finance would be referred to as a finance which would be as a home unit or as on a personal level. Corporate finance would be on an office level or a organization level. And public government finance would be for the economy of a country, state, that level of financing. The role of a finance is tax disclosures, tax opinions, review of legal agreements, accounting opinions, comfort letters, financial modeling, debt and equity, and corporate restructuring. These are some roles of a financer which should be given key importance to. And importance of a financer is generating money, organize operations, cash flow, strategizing funds, and management of unavoidable risks, new products and markets. So basically, a financer has to look that the organization's cash flow and liquidity is maintained and it is smooth so that it does not go in debt. And it has to see that the working capital is provided and it is in operation for smooth functioning of the organization. Types of finance: debt finance and equity finance. The other types of finances could be public, personal, corporate, and private finance. Talking about finance in aviation. Aviation financing sector exhibits the sort of characteristics that would attract institutional investors such as sovereign wealth funds, insurance companies, pension funds, and certain private equity funds. The industry has been recorded aircraft orders driven by the operational needs of airlines. Finding funds for these orders will be a challenge. In current economic environment of low interest rates and economic uncertainty, the aviation sector could offer an attractive alternative to new investors. Some question marks remain around financing of secondhand fleets as the values and rentals soften. And as we know that today's, seeing the current situation, investors are not really investing in aviation, but financing should come up with a strategy that would make or that would insist the finance, the investors to invest in aviation to boost the aviation industry. As we all know, it's on a down low and it is not in much of function except the cargo. The salary insight of finance in aviation would be is between 12.8 lakhs for employees between 7 years to 11 years, whereas a finance manager's salary at AAI ranges between 8 to 18 lakhs. And its estimates are based on salaries received from various employees of AAI. So these are just a few examples of financing. What is meant by SEO? So frankly speaking, I was not in much of knowledge of SEO until I had the chance to make this presentation. And I am glad that I got to know a lot about it in depth. So SEO refers to search engine optimization. And this is a job profile that is very much in demand. As we all know, much of the marketing and operations are performed online and it is all digital. So basically it is the process of improving the quality and quantity of website traffic to a website or a web page from search engines. SEO targets unpaid traffic rather than direct traffic or paid traffic. SEO, it's a never-ending battle to get more eyes on your website and convince Google that your site is worth sending researchers to. SEO, we all know for social media, we all are using social media these days, and you might have noticed that once you like a post, if you like a post about fashion or an aviation, that content will be more shown and more prone in your feed as this is all that comes in under SEO, and they know that if the customer is interested in such things, they will make it more prone and more to keep you more engaged on their sites to gain more profits. It is a broad term used to describe different strategies that increase your business's visibility online. You want the right people to find your business, and SEO brings those people right to your digital front door. Properly optimizing your website will help spread the word about your industry online, attract new customers, and earn you a good position in search engine result pages. So basically, how does SEO work? SEO works by optimizing your site for the search engine that you want to rank, whether it might be a Google, Amazon, or YouTube. Specifically, your job is to make sure that a search engine sees your site as the overall best result for a person's search. They determine the best result that is based on an algorithm that takes place into account authority, relevancy to that query, loading speed, and more. Search engine rank the organic search results based on hundreds of different ranking factors, but in general, organic results are deemed by Google to the most relative, trustworthy, and authoritative websites or web pages on the subject. Importance of an SEO: it builds trust and credibility. SEO means a better user experience, as it would make the user easy to find some information on the website or what they are looking for. It impacts the buying cycle. The best practices are always updated. Understanding SEO helps to understand the environment of the web. It is relatively cheap and brings new opportunities to light. Talking about SEO in aviation, if you want your aviation website to soar new heights, you also have to know that it is a constant work in progress, especially when you're dealing with search engine organization. It includes all of that and more, and utilizing it effectively, and it will work wonders for your business's online presence. It also creates content for aviation industry clients, smart marketing, aerospace marketing, and get more leads with less efforts. A salary insight of SEO, for example, in aerospace holidays, it ranges between 2.2 lakhs to 2.8 lakhs. And for a junior SEO, it might range between 1.1 to 1.4 lakhs. So yeah, these were just a few job